When the man with a bright-colored sweater walked through the door of the yellow-brown house, all we could do was give the widest smile, because the world's friendliest neighbor was on the screens of our TV. Fred Rogers was an icon for love and kindness. He taught valuable lessons that no six-year-old could learn by watching the television. So how much do you know about the creator of the show? We have listed a number of interesting facts about Mr. Rogers, but before you dive into it, don't forget to subscribe to our channel, tap the bell icon, and follow us on our other social media as well. Bullied as a child. Fred Rogers, who was welcomed into the homes of many families because of his genuine personality, had a tough childhood. As a child, Rogers, like any other kid, was shy and overweight. He did not have any friends and was a victim of bullying. According to Benjamin Wagner, the director of the 2010 documentary, Mr. Rogers and Me, Rogers was often taunted by his schoolmates and was called Fat Freddy. The poor guy would then cry through his fingers and make up songs on his piano. Began playing the piano at the early age of 5. During tough times, Fred found comfort by playing the piano. With the help and support of his family, especially his mother and grandmother, Rogers was able to develop himself as an artist. He soon picked up tunes on his modest family piano and was able to express his emotions. The little Rogers' first official piano was gifted by his Nana, which was a second-hand 1920 Steinway Concert Grand Model D ebonized piano. Rogers' mom knitted all of his sweaters. If you're planning to buy one of those brightly colored sweaters that Fred Rogers wore in the show, then get ready to be disappointed, because his mother knitted all those comfy-looking sweaters. The actor said during an interview that his mother would knit sweaters for all her children and gift them during Christmas. Mr. Rogers wore sneakers on set. After pulling down his cardigan from the hanger and zipping it over his shirt, Mr. Rogers would always switch his loafers with the good old navy blue sneakers. The major reason for him wearing sneakers was that it made much less noise and it was easier for him to run and move around behind the set. He was colorblind. While we consider those brightly colored sweaters as a trademark of the show, the host, Fred Rogers, might never have noticed it. He was red-green colorblind, which meant he never got to see the true color of his cardigan. He would have a difficult time distinguishing between tomato soup and pea soup, although he did like both. One time, while having lunch with his TV partner, Josie Carey, he asked her to tell him which soup was which. When Carey asked him, he liked both, so why not just dip in? "If it's tomato soup," he replied, "I'll put sugar in it." He responded to all his fan mail. It might be hard to believe, but Fred Rogers had a scheduled daily routine to reply to all his fan mail. He would cherish all the letters that the kids wrote to him and consider them sacred. Rogers would receive various kinds of letters. Some would be the typical gushy letter that you would write to an idol, and the rest were a bit different and dealt with personal problems that the kids faced back home. He would receive 50 to 100 letters per day and would reply to each and every one with great interest and enthusiasm. Savior of public television. Back in May 1969, the public broadcasting service was facing some serious financial crises. They were in need of $20 million in order to keep themselves functioning. It seemed impossible to impress the then Senate Committee Chairman, John Pastore, who was known as a tough guy. To save the day, Fred was called before the committee. But to their dismay, John had never heard about Rogers or his show. But that did not stop Rogers from spellbinding the man. He gave a quick demo and showed how important PBS was for the children. Within 6 minutes of time, the tough-to-break chairman melted and approved the PBS budget request. Not all heroes wear capes, now do they? What is the one thing that you loved about Fred Rogers? Share it with us right down below in the comment box. And don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel.